everyone, and welcome to the midweek. We have a nice one for you, a new one. I do not know that anyone in my country, at least, have tried this soap before. It's in the thumbnail, it's in the introduction, it's right here. It's MMPG. MMGP, yeah. Mr. Murray's Grooming Products. Afternoon in Capri. With Neroli, Orange, and Pettigran. It's a, let's see here, it says here, made in the UK. It is vegan, it says there. And has a lot of nice ingredients to it. Open it up. Let's see how much we get here. 114 grams. I believe that's about 4 ounces. Hard pack. Listen. And no dent at all to it. You can even take it out. Looks like this. Nice looking pour. The scent on this is absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. It is an homage to Acqua di Bama Essenza. Now, I have never smelled it, but based on this, I'm getting some Loire Noir vibes. Absolutely gorgeous. Gorgeous. Just come out of the shower, otherwise I'm not going to be using any pre-shaving product because I have an idea that this is amazing. All right. I'm not paid by MMGP to say nice things by them. I bought this with my own money from a shop called, what's it called, The English Scent from Germany. And hopefully soon we'll be able to get this in my own country. Fingers crossed. Had a lovely chat with Mr. Murray himself. Nice chat. But let's move on until we... You digress. Yes, I know. Brush this lovely Yaki Sagrada Familia, as in the church. 24 millimeter from Yaki. Good backbone on this one. Tuxedo knot. We'll be putting it in some water. Razor is going to be the Rex Ambassador, adjustable razor, short handle. On the aggressive side. I don't know if it's a blade feel-wise, but a good shaver. And I have it in this from AliExpress called Life Bin. I also have a... what's it called? Lalable. From, right, let's see how this works. Now, usually, there's more than enough room to lather here, but we'll try to see if we can scoop some out here with... This is just a teaspoon I'm using. Hold it here because the puck is sliding up. Let's see. Not this much. I think this is way too much, but we'll see. We will see. And this is how it looks. Now, took off a bit there. Hardly made a dent in it anyway. Gorgeous citrus scent with some muskiness. Just spreading it out in the ball here. Usually I would have done that before turning on the camera, but since this is a fellow European, not in the Union, you know, but the scent is amazing. There's nothing to pinpoint it in terms of scent quality. It's amazing quality scent. Scent strength, I'll put about 3. I have an idea. This is how it looks now. The fine ball. I have an idea that it's going to explode in the room. Right. Very warm weather today. Alright, let's have a go and see how this performs. Take the brush and flick it like this. And then we let's see how that works straight away. And I won't be holding up because I have a pain in my back, my shoulders, also irritating me somewhat. I have that for a few weeks now. It won't really loosen up. All right. Still working. All right. This is how it looks now. A bit airy at the moment, but I'm thinking that slightly more work is going to put that to rest. Now, how are you all doing? Right now, I am struggling with keeping the lather inside the bowl because it's actually exploding a bit on me as I am agitating it with the brush, all over the brush as well. And yes, the aerated soap is becoming creamier and creamier as we speak. The scent, as I expected, is exploding in the room, in the bathroom, and the lather is exploding, and therefore my initial thoughts was true. I think I've gone too much, but look at this, amazing. All right. I saw Paul H use a soap of MMGP, and I thought, that piqued my interest. And then I thought I'd use this specific look. Look at this. All right. I mean, you know, yeah, on the sides as well, everywhere, and the brush, like this, very hydrated, and down the sides on my hands, but it's also short-handled brush too, so we'll clean it up ever slightly, ever so slightly. We don't want slippery hands now, do we? I'm slippery enough as it is. Oh, sorry. All right. Let's try to see. That's better. All right. Let's just wet face. And we'll see how this performs. Oh, very damp weather today. I think I've been saying that for a few weeks now, but today's, it's very, very much. All right, very hot as well. Had a lot of fun this morning. All right, let's see how this works. No pre-shave, just water. Scent strength is about 4-5, in between that. All right. I just put a bit of the lather to the side. Okay, also got one. Second soap, about two, and that one has no scented, it is unscented, but it has menthol in it, that's why I went for it. All right, sitting on the face right now, feels good, no irritation, slide, there you go, yeah. All right, twist the bottom here, drops, and you can take out the top. Put away the razor. I'm only using the top. Place the razor in it like this. This is a mule. Second use? Yeah, second use. And you turn it in here, hold it, press up as you turn. You don't need to unscrew it in order to adjust it, and my goes to 6, and then one dot beyond about 7. Alright? Or 6.5. And let's wet it using cold water, not hot water. Cold water, also use cold water to lather, and it seems to be staying nice on the skin. Let's see. Will it protect me from a Rex most aggressive setting? Oh, that's good. Very nice. Nice residual slickness. Good. Rinse out. Cleans out nicely. And I have sensitive skin. It's toughened up shaving this way, actually. Also in terms of what might irritate you. Let's see here. Soon, I'm going to be growing out the goatee yet again. Alright, so let's see slickness. Nice. It reminds me of a famous American soap in terms of quality. Nice slickness. It reminds me of the HC&C soap base. Very good soap that. Just dip the brush, the tips. It's a very nice and posh scent. It's fancy. That's what I mean when I say something is posh. It's a fancy, fancy scent. There you go. All right, let's tune this down to setting 5 and see how that agrees with us. Stainless steel razor, very well made. Okay. Yes, I could have wetted up the soap even more so. And I'm one of those idiots who prefer this. Is that a bit more pasty? Nice knurling on the handle here. concentrating, that's why I'm quiet here. Right, good. Nice protection. Very nice. And this is usually on the last pass or the second pass when I cut myself. Again, no irritation, no stinging, that's no nothing. Dip in water to thin it up. Dip the entire knot in water and we'll see what happens. For those who enjoy this wet, I'll go here. I'm getting the orange, I'm getting the pettigran. And then the roly is not, to me, very dominant, but it is there. It is there. All right. We'll tune this down to about a 3. Isn't it? Yeah. See the top? If it wants to focus, that is. Come on. There you go. Last pass. And look how this lullaby is. It works. Thick. Pasty-like. Also works this way. A bit wetter. As you would perhaps, you at home would usually make it. Very nice slickness in this soap. It's good quality bits. Very much looking forward to the post shape feel. There's a lot of different butters in this, so you see. Oh, there's a dot. There you go, nice, good. The lala had stopped being slick here, but other than that, it has been giving me a nice shave up until now. Keep going over here as well. This razor can go mild and aggressive. Some say that even setting one is like more than enough for them. See this way. That's it. Nice. All right, let's give it a rinse, and I'll see you at all the post-shave. Okay. Oh, did I? Splashed water all over the mirror, and I thought I splashed water on you as well. All right, let's have a go here. Now, as I told you, I have sensitive skin. And the Ariana Nevis I tried did not suit me. No, suit my skin. Scent was lovely. That was lovely. Have a small dot here and here. Otherwise, perhaps a few nicks, weepers here, but that might be reopeners. Can't quite distinguish it. It's just my skin being, you know, my skin. Feeling great, actually. Post shave, nice. Sort of stickiness. Lovely scent. We'll just put on some face. Lemon, just to stay in the citrusy theme. I've added menthol to this, as in many others. Ooh, that's a nice one. All right, and we'll go through what we used. And what's the verdict? Rex. Good razor, aggressive, got me a few times here and there. The Mule Blade, second use, no overhang. Just be careful with it will bite you, as obviously seen here. Brush, 24mm from Yaki Sagrada Familia. Good backbone, and this is what's left in the bowl. Lots and lots and lots of lovely lather. I'm just scooping some out here. See the peaks? Very nice. Great slickness. Amazing scent, really. It's like I've smelled this before. Even though I don't. I know I haven't smelled the Aqua di Parma Essenza scent, but this somehow I know. So perhaps, you know, someday in the earlier years. And that brings us to this Mr. Murray's Grooming Product soap here. It worked well. Great slickness. Residual slickness is okay. It's actually good. Not okay, it's good. The scent is absolutely beautiful. I love the label here. Nice, fresh, sort of happy. And I needed that today, something happy. It's a hard pack, very hard pack. Scooped up a bit here. Off the top, about scent strength of 3-4, lathered up slightly more, between 4 and 5 scent strength. Great shave. I would love to have this as an aftershave as well. Just saying. If Mr. Murray watches this. Is it recommendable? Do I enjoy my purchase? Well, that's basically what it's about right now. And also perhaps while you watch this. Yes, this is worth the money. About 25 euros, I believe I got this for. There's a lot of shaves in it. In terms of soap quality, I would notch it to be on the verge of HCNC quality and also Noble Otter quality. If you know those soaps but do not know this one, this is about the same quality. Soap was not dissipating, and I don't have anything reminiscing to this wonderful scent at all. So I had something lemony, which is some time since I've used that, so I'm going with that. Muscle from Spain. We have been everywhere in the world now. We've been mentholated. into America with the Rex, all the way across the pond to Scotland with the soap. Also Faye's from here, from the States. Ah, this is lovely. More. And China with the brush. And the bowl is also from the States. I don't know if it's made in the US, I'm fine, but made in Holland, I believe. Maybe, I don't know, I don't know. Scratch that. I don't know where they make their bowls. Absolutely gorgeous shave, this. Feeling amazing. Ready to take on the world. But actually feeling a bit down today. So this came in at a perfect timing and had a gorgeous scent. I'm really looking forward to using their unscented, mentholated shave. So that's it, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned and stay happy and healthy, everyone. Bye-bye. I'll see you, hopefully, in the weekend.